Alright, this is the new video for the bike and, or trike and trailer. Give a little update. As you can obviously see, it's been painted. Color matched to the bike for the most part. As I stated in the previous video, the light bar has been upgraded. It's really hard to see, obviously, in the daylight just how bright that is, but it is very bright. I've removed that. As you can see, there's a different fork set on here. Unfortunately, we had a small accident with our front fork. We hit a curb and buckled the fork backwards, so I had to rebuild the front end. We also have a gear shifter installed now. Wonderful cup holder. There's our upgraded speedometer that I was planning on getting. It's all in. We have upgraded crank. I'll probably be going back to the original crank because the arms were longer, so I got a better stride, I guess you could say, out of it. We have the new hub, the new mid hub, rebuilt. Obviously, as you can see here, there is no gear for this chain right here to be hooked to. I'm waiting for that still. Ordered it, waiting for it to arrive. This remained the same. There's a 44 in the back and a 22 here. This is what got upgraded. There is now a free wheel in there. So when the trike rolls forward, it can free spin independently from the motor. It's not forcing the motor to move at all times. Box has been rebuilt. Larger box. In it, we finally have our cooling fans installed. They move a heck of a lot of air. There's the heat sinks. One is blocked off because obviously there's nothing on top of it. And then we have our controller box sitting on top of a heat sink. There is a gold heat paste in between here that allows for the heat dissipation. As you can see all the way around the edge, there's the sealed foam tape. And then right around the chain drive, you'll see that there's foam around the chain drive so that the chains stay sealed in for the most part, which means when I close the lid, all the air that these fans draw in get pulled past that heat sink right there, help to keep the controller box cool. I've got another thing that I still have to build that's going to install three individual fans right on top of here that'll push air through the back of the fan and allow it to come out right here through these holes. I created the box larger, so eventually this is a 12 volt 35 amp hour battery. One more will fit right next to it snugly. Lights are hooked up. We have obviously the trailer harness. It hasn't changed a bit. We have the 3-pin harness here. That's what allows me to charge the 24 volts inside of here. And then we have the 8-pin. And then that just, like I said, that controls the lights and horns. As you can see, there's that. Turns that on and off. And then we have, can't really see it, hold on, there's the dome light. If I hit the switch for the dome light, there you go. And then moving our way back, I went with, this is a bed liner. It's what you would just say. I bought it from like AutoZone. It's just a roll-on bed liner, nothing fancy. It does take a serious impact though. And then I color matched and went with the blue all the way around. Finally got the upgraded license plate. It has both of my daughters on it. for the light bar all the way around. First aid kit's back on. I think it looks better in the blue. It makes it stand out a little bit more. You can see there are just, I used clear VHB mounting tape. And then this is literally just a vinyl tablecloth. And I used an industrial heat gun to heat it up and shrink it a little bit. Vinyl doesn't shrink much, obviously, but it still helped to shrink it and tighten it up. Stereo. These still open. Our amp is in there and installed now. Everything's wired in. Subwoofers. They're nothing major. I didn't need to. I mean, they're obviously sitting right behind the kids, so I didn't need them to be that loud. But it definitely cleans the quality of the music up. As you can see, they definitely move. They clean the quality of the music up quite a bit. These are allowed to do their high, their mid, and then the subs. The subs do the bass. Yes, baby. I see. I've been able to, this is finally mounted and in place. I've gotten one of the safety harnesses in. I haven't gotten the other one in, but everything's pre-drilled. I can't even get back there to see, so there's no point. But everything's pre-drilled. All I gotta do is run the razor blade through to get the slits in. One thing I didn't do in the previous video, today I do have my keys on me, so we're gonna go through this. We're gonna set this down for a second. Gotta unlock this. All right. Under the trailer, we have this wonderful compartment. It's got the horns attached to it. There's a little cooling fan in there as well. Now, right there you see the wonderful little lock. The reason that this little box stays locked is because the brains of the trailer are in here. There's an entire alarm system, siren. There's the LED controller. Speaking of the LED controller, that one will be coming out. And I actually just got this right here, which will allow me to control, well, not control the LEDs, but the LEDs will now be controlled by the music. See, I said there's a backup battery. That's the backup battery. It's not much. I believe it's a 7 amp hour. But in the event that for some reason the main battery dies, there's our cooling fan. The cooling fan comes on when I turn these lights on. There's one air compressor, two air compressors. Air hoses go through there. All of our relays, they run the air horns. Their main harness. So it allows everything to run up and run through. Full 110 decibel siren. You set it. It's a little remote it came with. And it's got a horn. Warn feature. God. But I obviously can't park this anywhere into a bicycle rack, so I had to be able to put something on it to keep it safe. see again with the harnesses. There's one right there. The other one will go right there. And then those are the slits for this strap right here. Suspension hasn't changed a bit. Oh. I think that's just about all the updating that I've done so far. I have already pre-ordered everything for building the differential back here. I've ordered two freewheel adapters that'll go one here and one here. Two freewheels, and then there will be mounts that bolt these bolt holes through the freewheel. This axle will get cut down the middle so that both of my tires become drive tires. And then, like I said, there's no gear there. I have a 3-speed, a 16, 18, 21 that'll be threading onto there shortly. And that'll allow me to assist it through, you know, different speed levels. That's where our fans go. In there. Not much else. I know this is my drive room right now. This room is completely shot. It's bent all to bejesus. So I will be going with the same company that I got these from. And I'm going to order two. They're 2 3/4 inches wide, so they're much wider tires. And they'll be designed to handle 375 pounds a piece. So, it's over there, baby girl. They'll be able to do 375 pounds a piece. I will just weld the axles right to the center of them, so then they'll just slide right in through those bearings. As you can see, I don't ride it right now. I've already replaced 5 spokes. There's another broken one. Trying to find the other ones. There's another broken one right there. And then up. There's our last one right there. The pressure of turning is ripping standard spoked rims. So I have to upgrade to something that doesn't really have spokes. It's a little bit more rigid. I guess that about covers it. Ashlyn, come here. You can say hi to everybody? No? Do you like your trailer? Do you like your trailer? Mm-hmm. What do you like best about your trailer? Good talk. I guess that about sums it up. Again, as with all of my videos, if you have any questions, comments, concerns, anything like that, don't hesitate to ask. Usually everything comes right to my cellular device, so I can usually answer quite quickly. But if you have any questions about how I did anything or want to, you know, start the project yourself, I'd be happy to walk you through the process. I will let you know. It is a giant undertaking. It is not just a weekend project. But like, share, comment, and if you can, I know that my GoFundMe account is attached to the videos as well, usually, if you can help out. Because building large projects like this for my kids is starting to outweigh the joy of it. Thanks for watching.